So far in this tutorial, we haven't really cared too much about where our objects are landing. Let's say I wanted the head in the center of the body. I don't know exactly where it is. I can try and eyeball it, but I'm not certain. So let's be certain. And I want to introduce you to guides and snapping. This is going to help us achieve this goal. So we'll start off with guides. How do we get those? Well, there are a couple of ways of doing it, but one of them is to go up to View and Guides here. Click on that. This box appears. This is our guides box. And you can see here on the left, horizontal and vertical guides. I want to center this party goer right in the center of our canvas, our document. So I'm going to click on this little icon here and add one. So that has automatically added one to the center of the document. And if I click on the horizontal one as well, that will also go into the center. So this is the absolute center of our document. So that's very handy. If you no longer want these guides, you can just select them and click on the bin. Or you just press remove guides there. You can also change the color of them, but I suggest just leaving them until you get familiar with Affinity. Okay, let's press close now. So we're ready to try. So I'm going to click on the body and try and move him to the center. But as I do it, you can see, well, it's not kind of centering. It's still just moving wherever it wants to. Well, this is where we introduce snapping. If we go up here, there's a magnet icon. If we click on that and we go back to our body, I can click on it and move it. And now you see it's kind of snapping. It's acting like a magnet to that guide, which is really helping us to get it centered. So let's go and have a look at these options because you can see a little arrow next to it. I'm going to click on it and something to note is just candidates, yeah? These are kind of presets of all of these boxes that are ticked. Right now, it's considering what to snap to. So I said, I want immediate layers as the options to snap to. What are my immediate layers? Well, all of these shapes around them, they're immediate layers. If I want to do candidate list, I can click on that. This goes further into it, but we're just going to start off with immediate layers. And if you can see the other option there, immediate layers and children. Remember, they're not actually talking about children. They're talking about a shape that maybe you have clipped inside another shape. And then all layers as well. So looking at these options, one of the ones that we definitely want is snap to guides. And that one is selected, so I'm happy with that. So let's go ahead and close this. And as you can see, when you snap into the center, it's green on the vertical axis there. And if I just go down slightly and I snap to this one, you can see it's red, the horizontal axis. I don't really care about that one right now. All I care about is getting the body centered. Okay, moving on to the head. Let's just grab that and drag it across. You see, it's very easy to get centered. So I'll drag it up to about there. I know that they are completely centered. And for the hat, I don't really need the snapping on right now. So there's two ways you can go about this because you can see as I'm trying to place it where I want, it keeps snapping to areas I don't need. So one of the options is to go up to snapping, turn it off, and then you can move it around and it's nice and smooth. Or you can keep it on. And then when you've clicked and dragged on it, you see right now it's still happening. I can hold my finger on the Option button or the Alt button on the keyboard, and now it temporarily disables it. So I can place it wherever I want there, let go, and you see snapping is still activated across the document. Okay, so we've sorted out our party goer. Let's move him off to the side a little bit and show you another way of using guides. So I don't always have to go up to View, Guides, etc. What I can do is just go up to these rulers, either on the top or the left, and just click and drag down, and that creates a new one. So maybe I'll place one here. So I'll drag this square over here and just snap it there. You can see on the vertical axis, it's green. On the horizontal, it's red. That lets me know that it is touching those guides. Okay, let's drag this one across here and snap that into place. And this one, just to make sure, I'm going to drag it up here and there. If you want another vertical, you just drag from the side. Okay, by the way, if you want to get rid of these, you can just double tap on any of them. So I double tap that one. And you see it brings me through, it highlights the vertical guide that I just double tapped. If I no longer want that anymore, I just press the bin icon. If you want to get rid of all of them, of course, remove all guides and press close. So I hope that was useful. Here's another scenario. Let's say I take this box and this box here and I place them together like this. And I can see the snapping is helping me determine whether they are together. But if you want to be extra sure, you can go up here into view mode and click on wireframe mode. When I click on that, you see it's just showing us kind of faint colors, but it's showing us the outline in black so we can really tell whether they are together or not. And that is completely snapped together. If I go off of it slightly, and let's say I just move it in a little bit, and I go on wireframe mode, you see it's showing me that it is overlapping. And if I want to be really sure, I can just do this, click off of both of them, and you can see there's no overlap there.